My name is Sarah Butts. I'm head of the European Social Surveys Fieldwork Team and project manager for the CERES project. Monitoring fieldwork is essential for the success of any survey, but the problem is that for cross-national surveys, researchers are often quite far removed from the data collection process, and they're trying to monitor fieldwork across multiple countries, often with very different fieldwork contexts and with different local technologies and setups for fieldwork monitoring. Fieldwork monitoring requires access to data, but all too often researchers are relying on fieldwork updates that are incomplete, out of date, and not consistent across countries, which leaves them with an incomplete picture of how fieldwork is going and makes it difficult to ensure that quality standards are being implemented consistently across countries. Building on the success of SHARE's existing sample management system, under CERES, the FMS has been developed as a mobile app known as Case Control to be used by interviewers in the field to manage their caseloads and to collect contact information about all sample units. Case Control syncs automatically with a centralised case management system, which is available to fieldwork agents in each country to do day-to-day fieldwork management, and to the central survey team so that they can have access to data and summary progress statistics about all countries in the field at the same time.
Hi, I'm Iggy van der Wiel, developer at Centerdata, and for the CERES project, I work as lead developer for the fieldwork management system.
In the next part of the video, I will go deeper on the architecture of the fieldwork monitoring system. The architecture exists of three components. In this picture, I only show two. So at one side, we have the server where it holds the sample control. On this server, you will import your sample. That is the complete Bruto sample which you want to interview. And besides that, of course, you have to enter the contact informations, which you can import via Excel. When you have done that, the sample control will distribute it to interviewers, and that we call the case control. The case control application can run on multiple devices. So ideally for contact registration, you will use the phone. But you can imagine that some interviewers now use small tablets, and then you don't need a phone, but you can directly do it on a tablet. If you conduct your actual interview also via the system, sometimes with long interviews, of course, the laptop is still the most ideal, and then you can contact your register your contact attempts there. So it will go from the sample control to the case control. There your interviewers can conduct the actual interview and update the address information, phone numbers and email, and you record the metadata, which are the contact attempts. So to summarize, for the sample control, you have your address information, you have your last names. In some service, of course, you even are not allowed to import last names on a researcher level, so it's really only on an agency level. You have your preload from previous waves, and sometimes from some surveys you can also register proxies in case of the respondent themselves cannot answer the questionnaire, but they have a proxy like a relative, a brother or a mother who can do the interview. Then you will distribute your sample over different interviewers. They will do collecting the actual interviews, but you have to monitor your fieldwork. So for the case control, again summarizing, you register contact attempts, you make appointments to conduct interviews, you will do the actual interviewing. You do not know beforehand who you want to interview, so you can even do a screening or do a household composition to know who is in the household if you have a survey on a household level. And you can update contact information like addresses and what you mentioned before, the proxies or stable addresses. So the last step of this video is how you do your actual monitoring. So this is good for you as an agency to see how you can monitor fieldwork, or if you as a researcher, how you can cross-nationally monitor fieldwork. So we first start monitoring at the national level within the agency. So as you can see, currently we use the share as an example. This is on a household level survey, and here per interviewer you can see the different states that the households have. So at a glance you can directly see how your interviewers are performing, how many complete interviews on the household level they have, or if they have refusals or another state. But if you really want to look at an individual level, that's also possible. So below you will see all the interviewers with the respondent outcome codes, and for this one the 121 is a complete interview. So for this picture you can see we are really at the start of field work. For an agency, of course, looking at this data, maybe a manager, then they will contact a fieldwork coordinator to go directly to look per interviewer. So you have a list of all your interviewers. You can even see here if they already synced, yes or no, because maybe they are further in process but they forgot to sync the application. So that's of course the first point to look at. If that is all looking okay, then you go into an interviewer, and that part we will demo within actual Hangouts interview, so that will be later on. So finishing the monitoring within the country, we will go to the next part, which is the cross-national monitoring. So some surveys do not start at the same time per country, but they will shift in dates. So this gives a nice overview of all your countries and when they started and if they synced their national server to the central server. So as you can see here, every country bravely syncs their server to the national one. Maybe sometimes they missed some weeks. I think this one was during Christmas, because then the agency was closed. So this gives a nice overview if the agency syncs correctly, and giving you all the information you need. And then you can go on for each country, see some summary reports. We also included some graphs, as you can see here, some important one. This one is the number of interviews done of your sample. So you can enter projections for each week what you expect they should do, and then you can see if they really achieved it. Of course you can also enter a previous round to see what they have done last wave, and the next graph is showing you how many contacted attempts you have of your complete sample, and this one shows you, okay, the whole sample is contacted, so that's okay. But of course you can have some refusal rates, so this graph shows you how many percent of the sample is contacted. So for this graph it really looks okay, because almost 100% of the sample is contacted. But of course the response rates are different, because you can have some refusal rates. So in this video I introduced you about the fieldwork monitoring system, what the purpose is to improve monitoring of your fieldwork, how it's actually done with an app to real-time record contact attempts. Then on an agency level you can directly monitor your interviews, and on a cross-national level you can see how every country is doing their fieldwork. The next step is how you install the server on an agency level within the agency, and how you can download and install the application on your mobile device. Further information is also available on the service website. There you can download a PDF that gives you more technical information on how the program was developed and how you can use it within your own survey.